Hey, YouTubers out there, Cyclonus here, and one of the big issues that I wanted to talk about today is the oil industry is basically crying poor. And basically, what they're doing now is they're going to Congress and they're begging for money. $25 billion, okay? And to me, this sounds preposterous. Now, why would I say such a thing? Well, for one, they're bailing out the wrong folks, because in the end, when we look at this from a taxpayer point of view, it is the American people that get screwed in the end. Why? Because we have to pay, basically, for this bailout. And I'm very curious as to where the Congress is getting all this money from. And what's even more puzzling is that these oil makers who get this money, you know, what they'll do, this is exactly what they'll do. They'll take this money, they'll put it into their bank accounts, and then they'll say, okay, we're all set, we're not broke anymore. But, of course, you know, I'm delusional, so maybe I'm just not seeing the whole picture. Maybe I'm just not seeing the fact that, well, my taxpaying dollars is being used to bail out companies that basically should have known better. What Congress should say to these oil makers is that the following. They should tell them that they should stop making petroleum-based cars and start making fuel-efficient, non-petroleum-based vehicles. They should make vehicles that are cost-effective. They should make vehicles that are environmentally safe. And basically, in a nutshell, just make American cars, but make them in such a way that there's no reliance on foreign oil, there's no reliance on any other country that can hold us by the balls yet again for more money, because that's what this all is all about. But you see, if Congress did that, then the oil companies, in turn, will jack up the prices of oil again and start crying poor, as they have been doing for the past 5 or 10 years. And what's more puzzling in this whole thing is that the oil industry, they knew that this was occurring, that this was bound to happen. Not the crash of the economy, but the slowdown. They've been seeing this coming for months. If not, they've been probably seeing this for years. But they're so stupid and complacent in doing absolutely nothing that basically, in a nutshell, they dug their own graves. And as a result, it's the oil workers and the American taxpayer that has to suffer because of their stupidity. Nevertheless, Congress, like always, will bail these companies out. These companies will then have these huge $500,000 vacations, their bank accounts are fat, and basically, the American taxpayer, again, is broke. And then they wonder why people can't afford their homes. Well, of course, that's another video, but in itself, what this all amounts to is basically putting band-aids on a wound that basically is sick. And you don't put band-aids on a wound that does not heal. You basically give it medicine so that way, you can heal it. But putting band-aids on a problem like this is not going to rectify the situation. Unfortunately, what will happen is that Congress will give this money to the oil industry, and the American taxpayer will basically be more in debt. And again, this is all by your Congress, all by our stupid elected officials. All they can come up with is giving money, more money, to these companies that have money. I'm not sure how they can cry poor when they have all this money already. But again, who am I to say this? I'm not an economic person or a congressman who's privy to all this information. I'm just the average Joe Blow who basically just does not like to get screwed out of my taxpaying money. Unfortunately, people will go about their everyday lives and ignore the fact that they're getting screwed yet again by their own elected officials. As long as gasoline is $2 a gallon, as long as there's a roof over their heads, the American people will do absolutely nothing. They will not hold our own elected officials accountable for all this money that they're dishing out while people are losing their homes, their jobs, and most importantly, their hope in their own government to solve this problem. Because let's face it, this is a problem, and it's not going away anytime soon. In my opinion, they should get rid of every single politician and start fresh because we need new ideas. These old jokes of congressmen and senators basically are embarrassing the founding fathers who must be turning in their graves over basically destroying not only the American economy, but the confidence of the American people in the very system that the architects of the Republic initially created. So, again, that's my rant, and just thinking about this, $25 billion to these thugs that basically are just gonna put it in their bank accounts just makes me angry. But again, who am I to say? Anyways, ta-da.